Hi, I'm Tiffany Haddish, and this is Don't Text Your Ex. Where's my phone? Perfect. Now, I have some questions here from some Bumble users. Let me answer your questions and remind you why it's important not to be texting your ex. Because we got to move into the future, okay? My ex has a serious girlfriend, and I can't stop comparing myself to her. When will it start to feel better? Let's be honest. He your ex for a reason. And or she your ex for a reason, okay? You comparing yourself to his new girl, friend and or boyfriend, whatever it may be, has a lot to do with you. So you need to figure out what's going on with you. What's good about you? And don't forget why you broke up with that person, okay? And remember, you are amazing and you are good and there is somebody out there for you. I saw my ex on Bumble and now I want to stop swiping. What should I do? Now, let me just be clear. When you swipe left, that sends them away, right? I already did that, been there, done that, know that story. No thank you. That's like when you was a kid, right? And you would go to the park and you know this one particular slide you would get on, if it was hot outside, it would burn your butt. So then you know, I'm not getting on that slide on today. That's that relationship. Swipe left. Now let's see what else there is to offer. Oh, look at that. He finer than the ex. Our first date didn't go super well, in my opinion. How do I let them know I'm not interested without being mean? Boom. After date one, if you're feeling like, I don't know if I'm comfortable with this guy, I'm not really interested in going on another date, and you don't want to be rude, like, and just ghost them, you can say, hey, I know you were inviting me out again, and unfortunately, I've moved on. Or, you seem like a great guy, but maybe not the guy for me. You're perfect for somebody, though. That's my favorite one. You a good man. Just not good for me. Keep at it. What do you wish someone would have told you about dating when you were younger? Ooh-wee. I wish they would have told me that it's actually more expensive for a woman to go on a date. Let me break it down for you. First of all, you gotta get your hair done, okay? That right there is anywhere minimum of $50 to $120. I'm a black woman. Then you gotta put your makeup on. Good mascara, the kind of, cause you don't want, what if you go on a physical date where you're sweating a little bit? You don't want that stuff running down your eye. Now, halfway through the day, you look like a raccoon. So that's already $25. Then your outfit, okay? Your outfit, you wanna look attractive. You don't wanna seem too expensive, but maybe you do wanna seem expensive. Whatever it is, your outfit costs money. Your undergarments cost money in case we get lucky, they got a match. Now that's $100, you know what I'm saying? And you need to be semi-healthy. You don't wanna be on a date sick. So you gotta keep your immune system up, so you're taking your vitamins. It's expensive. I wish they would've told me how expensive it is to date. Nobody ever tell you that. Look, you spent all 2020 by yourself, getting to know yourself, making yourself your best self. Why not share that with somebody else?